And now, a relatively short story from Grumpy Grandpa Pandemonium, The Hat of Gold, or in Marathi, Sonyachi Topi. Once upon a time, long, long ago, an old woman lived with her son and daughter-in-law in a remote village. All was well in this small household, except for the fact that the old woman yearned to see the chubby face of a grandchild. But years passed by, and despite many prayers and pilgrimages and vows promised to be fulfilled should her wish be granted, called Navas in Marathi, to almost all deities, there was no sound of any toddler squeals in her home. Finally, out of sheer desperation and frustrated with the non-obliging deities, the old woman called out to the devil, Shaitan himself. Oh, great devil, Satan, Beelzebub, Lucifer, Pandemonium, whatever be your name, please bless me with a grandchild and I will gift you a hat of gold. In a flash, there was lightning and thunder and the smell of a rotten fart, and a devil resembling this author appeared before her. Okay, old hag, cackled the apparition, flashing his gold-filled chipped dental cavities. I, the devil, will grant your wish, but will you promise to keep your promise? Will you promise to give me a hat of gold? A bit startled by the sudden entry and surprised at the quick response to her appeal, the old woman swiftly gathered her wits and replied, Yes, O great devil, it's my Lord's promise that if you grant me a healthy, wealthy, happy, long-living, obedient grandchild who will happily play with me in his palace along with his parents and siblings, I promise to gift you a hat of gold. This seemed a simple enough wish to grant in exchange for a hat of gold for the devil, and he readily agreed. He plucked a strand of grey hair of the old woman as proof and witness of her promise and disappeared at once. Soon enough, true to the devil's promise, the old woman was blessed with a bonny, bouncy, cute grandchild. The old woman's joy knew no bounds and she was busy tending to her baby grandchild's care and upbringing. As per the other conditions, the old woman was soon blessed with more grandchildren, and the whole household soon moved into a grand palace where she lived merrily and happily with her family. However, the wicked devil could not bear to see her happy and reappeared before the old woman and demanded his hat of gold. The old grandma readily agreed to fulfill her promise and bade the devil to please come the next day and collect the promised hat of gold. The whole night, however, grandma was busy sewing a hat of the coarsest cloth for her dear grandchild, and as soon as it was ready, she put it on the head of her dear grandchild. Early the next day, the devil came to claim his hat of gold. At once the old grandma took the hat off her grandchild's head and flung it hard upon the devil's face. Here is your hat of gold as promised. Now get lost and stay lost, said the old grandma. But, sputtered the devil furiously, this is an ugly hat of the coarsest cloth. It is not of gold. Hearing this, the old grandma smiled cunningly and called out to her grandchild, Dear grandchild, what is your name and is this your hat? The innocent grandchild said, Why, dear grandma, how forgetful of you. It was you who insisted on naming me gold. And yes, it was my hat before you threw it on the face of this stranger who looks like a grumpy old grandpa Pandemonium. At this, the old woman triumphantly looked at the devil and said, Is this not a hat of gold? टेक्निकली आई फुलफिल्ड माई प्रॉमिस टू यू, फॉर आई हैव गिवन यू अ हैट ऑफ गोल्ड. नाउ बी गॉन बिफोर आई वैक योर बैक साइड विथ माई ब्रूम ऑफ थॉर्नी थिसल्स. हियरिंग दिस, सो स्केर्ड वॉज द पुअर डेविल दैट यू वैनिश्ड फास्टर देन ही हैड अराइव्ड, बिकॉज he knew that the old grandpa was a woman who was true to her words, and thus the old grandma lived happily ever after with a grandson, Gold, and her family. And that is the reason, dear friends, that all lawyers are picked up by the devil, lest any other human cheat him on technical legal grounds again. But never again did the devil dare to interfere with grandmas and their blessings for their grandchildren. And hence it is that every kiss that a grandchild gives and receives from his or her grandma drives the devil far, far away. Moral of the story, grandmas are wise enough to outwit even the devil. Better listen to them. May our story be short and funny. May your life be long and happy. Result of my nocturnal activities, a short story rehashed by Grumpy Grandpa Pandemonium, also known as Paragraje. Author's note, this story is dedicated to all those who now and again come hail or hellfire without fail to care of me and help me. Late Mr. Bhalchandra and late Mrs. Shobhatai Pednekar, an extremely rare to find couple who nursed and cared for me for many years. Mr. Sunil and Mrs. Neelima Mane, Vandana and Santosh Asarekar and their daughters Ayushi and Swarali, Namrata and Kiran Rane, Rekha Pange, Nihar and her family, Abhijit Saubal, my nurse Abhijit Kulkarni and his father who bandaged my wound regularly, Mr. Mahesh and Mrs. Nitya Mane, Kishore Ojha and to all medicos, and to my and everyone's milkmen and garbage men and all those people without whose daily essential services we cannot survive beyond a few days, with many, many thanks. Story narrated to me by my friend Mrs. Seema Kolle as an ancestral hand-me-down tale from her grandmother. The original is in Marathi language. Thank you, dear listener.